Hello, everyone. We just finished our ladies' Bible study, which is usually held every Thursday at 11 a.m. We also have men's Bible study every Wednesday at 7:30 p.m. And of course, everyone is welcome to come. Today, I wanted to talk to you about the importance of studying and reading the Word of God, the Holy Scriptures. I think it's very important for us to know as Christians that reading the Holy Scriptures on daily basis, regularly, is food for our soul. As we talk about the importance of reading the Holy Scriptures, I'd like to share with you this beautiful story. I just love how this story illustrates the changes that reading of the Holy Scripture brings in our lives. So the story is about an old man who is living on a farm with his grandson. And this man has a daily routine, and part of his daily routine is that every morning he wakes up, he sits at his kitchen table, and he reads the Holy Scriptures, the Bible. So the grandson, who looks up to his grandpa, of course, he's trying to do everything like his grandfather. He's trying to imitate him. And then one day he says, I'm going to start reading the Bible just like my grandfather does every morning. So he starts reading for a few days, and then he goes to his grandfather with a complaint. He says, Grandpa, I've been trying to be like you and reading the Holy Scriptures, but most of the things I read, I do not understand. And some of the things that I do understand, the moment I close the book, I forget about them.
What good is it to read the Scriptures anyways?
The grandfather quietly turns from putting coal in the stove and he says, Grandson, we can talk about this, but before we do that, I have a task for you. He says, I want you to take this coal basket to the river and bring some water for me. Grandson does as he's told. He goes down to the river to bring some water with the coal basket. But by the time he is away from the river, I don't know, 10 feet or 20 feet, there is no water, so the basket is empty. He comes home empty-handed. He says, Grandpa, by the time I try to get home, the water leaked out from the basket, so there is no water. I came empty-handed. The grandfather says, Grandson, you are not trying hard. You have to run really fast. The grandson goes again, and of course, he returns back again empty-handed. He says, Grandpa, I tried hard, but still, I cannot bring any water with this basket. I might as well take that bucket and bring some water with the bucket. The grandfather says, Grandson, I didn't ask you to bring a bucket of water. I asked you to bring a basket of water. So let's go outside. You have to try really hard and you have to run as fast as possible. At this point, grandson knows that this is mission impossible, but he says, this is my grandpa, so I have to do. He goes again and he fills the basket and he starts running as fast as possible. But of course, by the time he gets home, he gets to his grandfather, the basket is empty again. The grandson says, you see, Papa, I'm telling you, this is mission impossible. I cannot bring any water with this basket. The grandfather looks at him. He says, you are saying this is impossible? Look at that basket now. He looks at the basket, and for the first time, he realizes how different the basket looks now. It's not anymore that dirty coal basket. It's now clean and shining. And he says, my son, this is what happens when you read the Holy Scriptures. You may not remember everything. You may not understand everything. But when you read the Word of God, it changes you from inside out. That is the work of God in our lives, to change us from inside out. As we read more and more the Holy Scriptures, God changes us and transforms us into the image of His Son. So, I know you all have busy lives, we all have busy lives, and it's really hard sometimes to sit down and give 5 minutes, 10 minutes to reading. Even if you cannot read the Holy Scriptures, at least have an opportunity to listen to the Holy Scriptures.
There are lots of radio
stations, there are lots of audio recorded Holy Scriptures, Holy Bibles, lots of videos on YouTube. So one way or another, try to incorporate the Word of God in your daily life. God bless you all.